The U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service is the lead federal agency responsible for managing the nation's fish, wildlife, plants, and their habitats for the continuing benefit of the American people. Several agencies in the federal government put our country's conservation laws into action, and the service's Ecological Services Program helps lead the way. In this presentation about environmental contaminants, we provide a short overview about the role of natural resource damage assessment in restoring fish, wildlife, and their habitats to healthy conditions following events such as oil spills or other hazardous substance releases. When oil or hazardous substances spill into the environment, fish, wildlife, and other natural resources can be injured. The U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service, along with other federal, state, and tribal partners, act as trustees for these resources. To fulfill the mission of restoring natural resources that have been injured by oil spills or hazardous substance releases, several steps must be taken. First, trustees conduct a natural resource damage assessment to determine the extent of injury to natural resources caused by the oil spill or hazardous substance release. Trustees then negotiate a settlement with the responsible parties for these costs, as well as the costs incurred by the trustees to assess the injury and damages. Once a settlement has been reached, the trustees begin restoration actions to benefit injured resources. Finally, the trustees monitor the completed restoration projects to ensure their long-term success. The primary benefit of the Natural Resource Damage Assessment and Restoration Program is that injured natural resources can be restored at no cost to taxpayers. Instead, the responsible parties pay for the restoration. This program allows all Americans to enjoy healthy waters and lands that are once again teeming with wildlife and safe for recreation. For the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service, this is Dave Harrelson. Thank you for watching.